Welcome to Solving with AWS Solutions, your deep dive into reference architectures built by AWS that are ready to deploy instantly in the cloud. I'm Allison, and I'm here today with Johnny, who's going to tell us about the QnABot solution.
Thanks, Allison. The AWS QnABot allows customers to quickly build a chatbot that responds to simple questions with answers from unstructured documents. It is a fully functional chatbot that can be deployed across multiple channels and devices.
All right, well, let's see how this works. Okay, so here we are. Can you take me through the solution?
Of course. So we've put together this landing page with all the important information for the solution. At the bottom here, you'll see additional resources on the right side. So you'll see you'll have access to the source code. This is where you're going to be able to extend the solution to fit your use case. You have the CloudFormation template. This is where you'll be able to deploy the solution into your account. And you have also access to an implementation guide with a step-by-step walkthrough of the solution.
Okay, fantastic. Can we focus on the architecture? Can you walk me through that, please?
Of course. So here are all the resources that will be provisioned once you deploy the solution. There's two main pieces. First, you've got the Content Designer UI. This is where you will be able to train the bot to answer all the questions that are important for your business. This Content Designer UI, you authenticate using Amazon Cognito. All the requests are funneled through Amazon API Gateway, which afterwards they are stored. And all the requests will also go to an AWS Lambda.
Okay, and does that cover the second part?
So the second part is the Lex Web Client UI. Mm-hmm. So the Lex Web Client UI is where your user will be able to interact with Amazon Lex, either through the UI or through Amazon Connect. So all the queries will be funneled to the AWS Lambda, where all the metrics will be logged and generated.
Okay, fantastic. Can you show me the bot experience? What is the user going to see?
Yeah, so we'll start by looking at the web client UI. So this is what the users will see. They'll be able to start asking questions to your bot. And I've set it up here where you can see that the bot has answered to a few questions that your user has asked.
Okay, so let's say I have a website and I have a list of customer questions that we've cataloged over time that I would like to put into the bot because we know we're going to need to answer those. Can you show me where I would put those questions?
So this is where you would go into the Content Designer UI. So this is your control panel as an admin.
Okay.
So this is where you would enter all the questions and answers that you think your customers would be asking your bot. It's really easy. All you have to do is press add here, and you can simply enter all the questions and answers for your customers.
Okay, fantastic. But what happens if there are questions that come in that I have not loaded into the bot? What would the user experience be?
So this is where the concept of Lambda hooks come into play. So if your user comes in and asks a question that you haven't logged in the bank of questions, then you can set up a function that calls an external API that will return dynamic answers to your question, to the questions of your users. There's also the concept of topics. This is where the bot really understands the context of the questions you've asked and is able to follow up with relevant questions to your users.
Oh, gosh, that's fantastic. Okay, so it automates a lot of what needs to happen. What happens if something doesn't go right, though? How would I troubleshoot this or be aware if there were problems with the bot?
Right. And this is why we've designed the CloudWatch Dashboard. So these are operational metrics for your solutions. Here you'll find things like all of the questions that your bot has received that they weren't able to answer. So you'll get an idea of how to optimize and make the bot smarter over time. And you also get a few operational metrics on how your bot is performing over time.
Okay, so for instance, if the bot were having latency issues and we're not responding quickly enough to answers, I would see a flag here, for
exactly.
instance?
Okay. So you'll see these graphs really go up whenever you start having issues with the bot.
Okay, well, fantastic. Johnny, thank you for walking me through the AWS QnABot. It did a really good job of explaining for me how this works and the AWS underlying services that support it.
Thanks, Allison.
We hope you've enjoyed this exploration into the AWS QnABot solution.
Check out the solution and many more on the AWS Solutions website.
Thanks for watching. We hope to see you again soon.